And back at World Pork Expo in Des Moines, Iowa, the opening day of the three-day show here at the Iowa State Fairgrounds. And we'll be back here again tomorrow as well, talking more about the issues facing the pork industry. An issue facing all of agriculture is communicating its message, the agriculture message to consumers, an accurate message to give them a better idea of where their food comes from and who produces it and how it's done. Well, the pork industry a few years ago started up the We Care initiative to help to project that image and to get that message out about the pork industry. And here to tell us about it is R.C. Hunt, president-elect for the National Pork Producers Council from North Carolina. R.C., thank you for being with us. Kind of give us an update on We Care.
Well, Mike, thank you. It's a pleasure to be here in the Midwest also. They don't let many Southern people come up here very often, but it is certainly my pleasure, and I have a tremendous respect here for the Midwest. Yes, we've had tremendous success with the We Care program. As you know, it started out as just an idea in the late 2008. It was a joint project with the MPPC and National Pork Board, along with producers all over the country. And as we sit here today, we have been amazed that the conformity and everybody getting on the train with this project is certainly a positive image campaign for our industry.
What are some of the things that you've done?
Well, as you know, our whole point was to prove to our consumers and our public that we were sincere about what we do as far as raising food animal. And with that, we've gone through an elaborate process of getting a lot of people certified through different quality assurance programs, PQA Plus, along with site assessments on our farm. And if I remember correctly, to date, we have approaching the 60, we're close to 70 some thousand individuals and producers around the country that have been certified, along with a tremendous number of site assessments up there, many, many site assessments. I know in North Carolina, I have three farms, and I've been certified, my farms have been site assessed, and it's a really unique process.
In other words, then the message back to the consumer is, hey, we are doing everything we can to make sure that we are producing our pork, taking care of our animals in the right way, doing the right things to assure a good, healthy product back to the consumer.
It's absolutely very well said there, Mike. You know, I tell my employees at the farm that we need to, everything we do every day at that farm, we have to pretend that someone's looking over our shoulder, a consumer, a housewife, an individual, an elected official. And every action and involvement we have with that animal in our facility, we have to pretend that, you know, every action we do, how would that appear in the public image? And so that's the starting point on this process, and this is what makes it very exciting, and it brings a very high conscious level to employees in your operation.
I think that challenge has been greater for animal agriculture, and then within animal agriculture, maybe for the pork industry even more than other segments. So many misperceptions out there, questions, whether it be about production systems or now again the issue of things like antibiotic use, things like that. These are questions that consumers have.
You know, I think one of the mechanisms of really initiating this program was that there is a lot of mischief with special interest groups that attack not only our industry, but every commodity and every industry in the country. And so this certainly helps deflect that process in telling the true story. What was amazing, though, we even have internal issues between farmers and retailers and people that purchase our product. We would have a situation where to have one particular retailer trying to one-up the other retailer for some competitive advantage. And I think one of the unique things about this program is we've set these people down and explained to them what our industry was all about, our performance standards, the ethical principles that we abide by. And we tried to get everybody on the same page, which is, I think, been a this We Care program will go down in history as one of the best image campaigns in our industry history.
And also a big part of it is the involvement in local communities by the pork producers.
It is. All of these farms scattered across the country are individual farm families. And it's not about just what you produce and what you make and what you're able to keep. A lot of times what you do and return back to your communities in the form of just providing leadership skills back to your community and both youth and different organizations, as well as financial contributions back to the community.
And we're seeing more producers kind of open up their operation to the public, whether it's through videos or asking people to come out onto their farms. And of course, precautions have to be taken for health reasons, but the more people become familiar with what you do and are comfortable with what you do, more you're building that trust with your customer.
Absolutely. I have been totally amazed at the number of companies, both large and small, that have developed websites that if some individual in this country wants to take a look at the way we produce pork, all they have to do is Google pork production, and they can access probably one of the most prestigious operations in the country to one of the smallest family farm operations in the country. And that's unique. I think pork producers are proud of what we are. We're proud of what we do, and it's nothing to hide. And so with that, it's been an amazing effort on a lot of people to just share in this, kind of take a different look at social media through internet and computerization, Twitter and texting and Facebook.
And of course, then you have the challenge, someone in the animal agriculture business that's a bad actor, these videos come out, someone doing something that's wrong, then you have to really intensify your efforts to make sure the public understands those are exceptions, those aren't the rule.
Absolutely. I promise you one thing, Mike. Unfortunately, we will and do have bad actors. The neat thing is that we will not support that bad actor. We will not participate with that bad actor. And it's kind of like Congress, what they're going through today. We have kind of a self-policing mechanism today, kind of what we would call close to an ethics committee.
Well, the We Care initiative is a very good program and really sends a strong positive message out to consumers about the pork industry. And can people find out more about the program?
Yes. One of the best websites to get more information about the We Care program is the porkcares.org. It's a great little website that you can access pretty easy. And I would certainly urge producers and people in your listening audience to look at that.
And finally, before I let you go, I always ask about crop updates. You tell me in North Carolina, you got off to a great start, but it's kind of turned dry now.
Yes, I saw probably one of the best springs in North Carolina's history. We got the corn planted, the soybeans, and of course, you know, we still are a tobacco state. But the crops just up to last week were looking as pretty as I've ever seen them. And believe it or not, I've seen a lot of corn in North Carolina this year. We have turned dry here in the last week. And we do need rain. I would love to have about an inch and a half of rain this week and maybe another inch and a half right around the pollination time. But I think so far we've had a good start in North Carolina.
All right. RC, it's good to see you. Thank you very much for being with us. And I look forward to working with you as you continue on through the ranks here at the National Pork Producers Council.
Mike, it's been my pleasure. Have a nice expo.
Thank you very much. That's R.C. Hunt from North Carolina, President-elect of the National Pork Producers Council. All right, with that, we will wrap it up. Day number one here at World Pork Expo. Again, remember, it runs today, tomorrow, and Friday. We'll be back here with another broadcast tomorrow, taking a look at more of the issues facing the industry, some of the trade issues, some of the environmental issues. So be sure to join us again tomorrow from the Iowa State Fairgrounds in Des Moines, World Pork Expo on AgriTalk.